One of the largest and ugliest bugs that we ever find on our farm is the white grub. We'll talk about that and how you get it under control, where you're gonna find it on your farm.
Okay, first of all, there are many different types of white grubs. I don't really care what it is. If it's an annual grub, if it's what they call the true white grub that often can live 3 years or more, doesn't matter to me. We've got a problem. If you see white grubs out there, they can really attack your crop. A lot of times we do find it in corn, but it could be in soybeans or any crop. Where we most commonly find white grubs is near shelter belts. These grubs seem to like willows and a number of other types of trees, so you usually find it there. The other thing is, since the true white grub can survive for more than just 1 year, if you've had a problem in the past in a field, it's probably going to be an issue again for another year or 2 or 3 years. So you want to make sure that you're treating this each time you're seeing a big problem. But the whole issue with that is this: there's no real great rescue option for white grubs. You have to do something at planting time.
All right, here's the other thing, Brian, is there's a lot of information out there saying, well, white grubs are really only a problem in corn. Well, they are a problem in corn, but they're also a problem in other crops too. I remember reading something that came out from a university that said, yep, they're rarely, if ever, a problem in soybeans. And I was out visiting a farmer who had a white grub issue and was going to have to replant his soybeans because the grubs were so bad. And I remember printing out that article and heading out to his farm, and I said, well, hey, according to this university, you don't have a problem with white grubs, but every shovel that we flipped over in his field had at least one white grub, if not more, in it. So they can be a problem in multiple crops.
All right, here's the great thing, though. When you see adults, like let's say it's Japanese beetles, or any type of beetle, some people call them June beetles, you see any of these great big beetles, you've got to kill them. Okay, you can't be thinking, well, I don't know if I'm at the economic threshold. No, you see some beetles out there, you go kill them. They're usually going to be, like I say, near shelter belts. They're just in areas in fields many times, so it's not like you have to spray the whole field. And you can spray them and kill them for $2 to $4 an acre. So it's no big deal, but if you can kill them right away when you see them, then they don't get the chance to reproduce, and you don't have the actual white grub, that worm, in your field next year. So get the adults under control, then you've got this thing taken care of. If you have to treat for white grubs, you could use one of the insecticides, Force, Aztec, maybe it's Lorsban or Capture LFR, something like that. But just understand, these bugs are huge. So to think you're gonna get 100% control with a normal insecticide rate, it's probably not going to happen. That's why you gotta thin that population out when you see them the year before in the adult stage.
And definitely don't count on your neonic seed treatments having a big impact on white grubs. Even at the really high rate, the 1250 rate, you're just not going to get grub control. So I agree with Brian. I like the insecticide, but I would focus it in furrow. You're not normally going to see the white grubs come up to the surface. They're going to be underneath. And then do some digging out in your field. See what you see for bugs. If you're still seeing some grubs out there, you may have to get even more aggressive.
Okay, when Darren says more aggressive, again, no rescue treatment. You've got to get that grub at planting time. So that's why we'd like to get the adult stage during the season. If you see adults, you know you had grub damage early on too.
Well, I wish white grubs just fed on our weed of the week. That would really solve a lot of problems for us. We'll show you what will stop this weed coming up next.